So with Namekian style, we chose some obvious ones, some of the, no, mostly the obvious ones.
Yeah, mostly the obvious ones. I mean, Overtime is a clear winner here. It's an event with a lot of people not running spheres or just not taking advantage of them right now. It rejuvenates one, which gains an anger from the mastery. You can mill your opponent for Dragon Balls. That's negligible. But you can get any styled energy combat card from your life deck. And a lot of our other cards, in fact, our other choices here are all energy combats, not by coincidence, because it gears for the style. Whether you're a Piccolo or Gohan, you can take advantage of all of these cards, especially Gohan's level 2 adds 2 damage to all your styled attacks. So all the Namekian energies that cost 1, all of a sudden, yeah, they're all of a sudden 1 for 5, 1 for 6. I mean, even if you want to build it physical, there's still room for those energies. There's no reason not to.
Namekian energy attacks just have such strong effects, mm-hmm. as you're going to see with these other cards, such as Namekian Onslaught here. It's 2 for 4.
No, 1 for 4.
1 for 4?
1 for 4. That's a shining attack. I mean, on Gohan level 2, it's 1 for 6.
Yeah, 1 for 4, and if you have 2 Dragon Balls in play, it gains Remain 1. You can use it twice. So
it rejuvenates secondary, so it gains an Anger 2. So it's 1 for 4, rejuvenate, gain an anger just by itself.
Yeah. And then if you have 2 Dragon Balls in play, you can use it twice, so it's a 2 anger card, which is very useful in Namekian.
Mm-hmm.
And there's not many cards that gain multiple anger.
Yep. Then our next choice is Namekian Palm Shots. Energy attack, another energy attack, 1 for 3. Hit, draw the bottom card of your life deck, and you may shuffle a Dragon Ball in play back into its owner's life deck to search your life deck for a Dragon Ball and place it into play. The key on this card is the wording. Draw the bottom card of your life deck. Great. Okay.
Excellent.
Not bad.
Replaces itself.
But you may shuffle a Dragon Ball in play, which means you can even shuffle the opponents into play. If you happen to into its owner's life deck. So say they steal your Dragon Ball, shuffle it back into your life deck. You're shuffling, so you get the anger from the mastery, and you can search your life deck for a Dragon Ball placed into play. Say they're playing something like, or name it Dragon Ball 1, right? Say they steal it from you. All of a sudden, shuffle it back into your deck, you play it back out under your turn. And that's a combo I used against you. You say it's not a combo, but it's still novel because of the mastery protection when Dragon Ball. So if you play Namek 1, Namek 5, they steal your 1, you play this, put 1 back in your deck, and then play back out, so you're back to where you started.
Additionally, it can help you in that if you have a really strong Dragon Ball and you don't have Namekian Dragon Ball 1 into play, like if you have 3, 5, or 7 in play, you can shuffle those into your life deck and stop the opponent from possibly then stealing it and put out a weaker effect like 6 or 1 and allow the opponent then to steal that.
Now, one key on this to remember is what we were talking about is the wording on these cards. Placing a card into play is not the same as playing it, that we found out in the old Z.
It's mentioned in the CRD right now.
It places it into play, which means you could play something like Namek 2 into play, but you won't get the effect.
Right.
So really the clear choice for that, if you're going to put one back into play, is Namek 1.
1 or 6.
Yep, 6. So you get the conditional effects. Yeah, constant effects. So the next card we have is our honorable mention, Namekian Finger Lasers. Again, another one costing energy. Can you sense a theme? Costs 1 for 3. Secondary effect. Rearrange the top X of your discard pile. X equals your POR plus 1. If you're using Gohan, that's going to let you rearrange at least the top 3. If you're Piccolo, at least the top 4. And then hit, you get to draw the top card of your discard pile. So if there's a card there you like, you can draw it if it's an attack. Even if you don't want to do that or you don't think it's going to be successful, rearrange it. You can put on the block that when rejuvenated gains an anger. So you could manipulate your discard pile very easily with that.
Yeah, a lot of discard pile manipulation. This kind of fuels, not only does it... is an energy 1 for 3, and it will draw a card, so replacing itself in your hand again. It also allows you to combo with other cards, like Ryan said, with those cards that, when rejuvenated, have additional effects, like that block that gains you 2 anger, or the physical attack that lowers your opponent's anger. Additionally, it allows you to combo with a Namekian Flying Kick.
Flying Kick, draw a top card, discard pile.
So you could
rearrange 4 cards, draw one with that, draw one with Namekian Flying Kick. Or what I try to do against you, it didn't hit, is put Namekian Flying Kick on the top. So hit, use that, draw Flying Kick, hit, draw the next card.
Right.
So, I mean, if you can pull that off, it's 3 attacks right there.
So who do we feel is going to be defining a Namekian? Well, I mean, obviously there's only 2
personalities. There's only 2 choices.
And which is sad, because I kind of want Nail. I think a lot of people want Nail.
Yeah.
So Nail.
Next set, Panini. But, I mean, I could go either way on this. A lot of people think Gohan is the clear winner. And I don't know. I mean, Gohan
has
merits.
His level 4 instantly gets you.
That's the edge
the game.
Gohan has. His level 2 helps you get to the level 3 quicker. And his level 4 is an instant win, practically.
As long as you have 4 cards with anger in the title in your discard pile, as soon as you gain anger...
You only need 2.
4. because you hit gain once you hit the level, you'll gain one anger, and then you'll shuffle in four cards and gain four additional anger, and then have five anger and win. It shuffles a card which gains you anger with the mastery, which interacts with itself.
Okay.
Yes.
So how much I know about Gohan. But I've been playing more with Piccolo lately. I like Piccolo. I like the play style. Piccolo can pretty much sit on his level 2. I mean, once you get from 1 to 2, it's awesome. Plus, his level 1 has a built-in 1 for 3. Gain an Aga, rejuvenate 1, so I like that. And his level 2, again, offers some control. It's a free rejuve, replaces itself, does 2 damage, just like we were talking about earlier with the black style. But I can see how a lot of people prefer Gohan. He's more physical-based, and a lot of people are running light on physical blocks these days. On top of that, his name cards are significantly better than Piccolo's, at least in this playstyle, because his one name card is a potential energy attack 1 for 10, and his other name card, if you can get 3 anger, which is fairly easy, Gohan's power hit, gain 2 anger, jump the level. It's a
power punch.
Power punch, right. So it gains 2 anger secondary. If you get the level, it's unstoppable and does plus 4.
Plus 5, I thought. Yeah, it does plus 5.
All right, there you go. So, shows you how much, again, I don't play with Gohan that often. But, I mean, I can see him being people's go-to choice over Piccolo because of those name cards getting better effects.
He's fairly strong, too. His level 3 is 400,000. So,
but he needs that because, in my opinion, his level 3 is the weakest of all of his levels. Yeah. His level 1 helps fuel you when you want to do extra damage and you want to set
and
up stuff
potential anger gain as well, because if you critical, then not only does his power allow for criticals, but if you critical damage, you rejuvenate, which gains you anger.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
So,
that's awesome.
So it's like you have 2 levels that fuel the MPPV portion of that deck.
Mm-hmm.
The 2 gets you to the 3, and the 4 makes you instantly.
If you want to beat Gohan, you got to get him stuck in the level 3. I mean, that's what you have to do. His level 3 power is a strong physical attack, does 6 damage, so he doesn't really take advantage of his high power levels. If you really want to pump out the damage with his level 3, you have to lower your own anger,
yeah,
which is a little counterintuitive to MPPV. So if you're going to beat Gohan, if he gets to 3, you just gotta keep him there.
Yeah. Try to do critical damage effects, lower his anger piecewise,
mm-hmm,
and keep him there. So Namekian.